Hello students, I am Prachi, art and craft teacher from St. Paul High School. Today our topic is monsoon season. With this topic, we will learn how to draw memory drawing. Memory drawing is one of the most important subjects. So, let's begin.
To depict an incident pictorially, you have to recall your memories and observations and bring them back to your conscious mind. That is called memory drawing. Draw a rough sketch of the human figure first, keeping in mind the size of the paper.
Draw the rough sketch using HB pencil, then draw the final drawing using the same pencil, and finally outline it with a black pen. This way, the drawing can be completed.
Understand the subject of the picture and try to imagine it before your eyes. Give due importance to the subject figures while composing the picture. Draw the main figures of the picture first. Compose the drawings of the main figures in such a way that they are placed in the center part of the paper. After drawing the main figures, draw the background elements related to the topic in the remaining spaces. Do not reduce the importance of the topic by drawing unnecessary background elements. Keep in mind that 3/4 part of the picture should be covered with the figures of the subject. For this, the figures in the picture should be drawn big. Draw the figures in the picture nearer to you in big forms and figures that are further away in comparatively smaller forms. While drawing trees, houses, mountains, etc., keep in mind the change in forms due to the distance from the main figure. Because of this, the three-dimensional effect will be achieved and it will prove to be effective. The coloring of memory drawing can be done using various methods. In some of these methods, coloring can be done in a short time, and in some methods, coloring will take a little more time. Draw an outline of the picture using a black gel pen or a sketch pen. Color the entire picture with flat coloring using different colors. To make the picture bright and outstanding, apply pressure on the crayon or pastel. Leave that part of the picture empty where you want it white.
Color one side with a light tone and the other side with a dark tone. Wherever the light tone and dark tone meet, rub that area with a light tone crayon or pastel to merge the colors. In this manner, shade all the parts where shading is required and complete the painting part by part. Use a bright and attractive color scheme to color the picture.